blame on that third year. I had to go and refocus in the summer to make those grades up just so I could have opportunity to show people what I can do on the floor. So if you can stay focused now and build that foundation of things you know you need to do, things you need to focus on, that's going to help carry you not only through high school, but to college. If you want to play college, how many of you want to play college ball? Go to college. Good. You want to continue education. One thing you'll learn is by being focused today, focused all day, every day, thinking about things, thinking about your future, thinking about what I'm going to do 5 years from now. You've got to have a vision as well. You have to look forward for the next 2 years. You got to prepare for that. You have to go and ask questions. Some of you are very young. Please don't be afraid to ask questions. That's why I was training and I had hands raised. I want to ask questions about you. I want to learn about you. The more I know about you, the more I'm going to learn about myself. The more I can get from you, the more it's going to help me. I don't know everything. I'm 40 years old. I don't know everything. I'm still learning. 15 individuals. Their efforts amongst those 15 individuals only for a couple hours a day. So you're only going to get 1/15 of their time and their knowledge for those couple of hours. You have umpteen amount of hours on a day that you can focus and work on your own game by yourself. And I think that's what sets a lot of players apart. When you talk about Kevin Durant, they talk about all the time. He's there till the lights go out. He's working on his game. And many people think he's sitting there with a coach and the coach is passing the ball. And that's not the case. Many times I went in the gym and I look forward to going into an empty gym. That way I can focus on my shot, focus on my ball handling, focus on things that I wanted to visualize was going to happen in the game the next day. So I think that was a big reason. Thanks for that question. For me being able to play such a long time. I also played 4 more years after I played in the NBA, played in China and the Middle East. So played about 16 years professional basketball. Any other questions? Good question. Because if you look at it from an individual standpoint, I had some of my best years in Cleveland. From a team standpoint, we had a good year when I was in New Jersey. We had won an Atlantic Division title. We lost to Shaq and Wade in 2005 when they won the championship. And, you know, as a team, that was my best team effort that I played on. But as a whole, you know, I think, you know, you go through ups and downs just about what we come back to. Refocusing on the next season, focus on getting better, focusing on what I need to do to eat right. Talked to a young lady here earlier. What did you say earlier? What did you eat for breakfast? Jack in the Box. Who else had Jack in the Box? Huh? There you go. What did you cook today?
Eggs and grits.
Eggs and grits? Ooh, you went old school.
Wave, Grandma.
To watch me speak. His name was Vincent Carson, great player. He was a great inspiration to me. My dad as well, he played here in Pasadena. I had cousins who played Tracy Murray, who was from Pasadena. He ended up playing in Laverne, Lutheran, and from Laverne at Door High School. But he's originally from Pasadena. Seven rebounds a game. I was a pretty good rebounder for my position. I played small forward. So, 6'7", might get you the ball. Go get the ball. Okay? That's what my dad taught me. If I'm getting the rebound down here, I don't have to give it up to the point guard. You don't want to throw me the ball in the post? I don't want to throw you the ball in the perimeter. I'll bring the ball in the court. So work on that in the summer. Work on bringing the ball in the court. Work on attacking and making the right play. You know? Just don't say, you know, I'm just going to do what everybody wants me to do and go stand in the middle of the paint or stand on the post and not get any action.
What players in the NBA that you feel remind you of yourself?
Oh, man, we were talking about that the other day. You know, it's funny, I was watching Carmelo, and when he first came in the league, not saying I was as good as a scorer as he is, but he, some of the ways that he scores on the floor, some of the same ways, similar to what, you know, the way I would score for my NBA career, putting the ball in my left hand a lot, posting up, mixing it up, hitting threes, hitting some mid-range step backs and stuff. So I would think that, you know, just the way he plays the game is similar to the way that I play. All right, I guess. Big as Shaq compared to me, he makes me look really small.
Ooh.
Right now, I'm about 260 pounds. So you add a whole nother 100 pounds on him in shape.
Wow.
Not saying how big he is, I don't know how big he is now, but I know. I know for a fact. About 7'1", 7'2". Big, wide, strong, athletic. You can bring the ball up the court, you grab off the rim and bring it up. With him. You know, he came in right after I was done playing. He's a dynamic jumper, dynamic player. You know, I wish somebody could help him with his footwork, but you know, that's a couple to figure out. Yeah, I dunked on Yao Ming. I got a chance to dunk on Yao Ming. I couldn't believe it. 7'6". You know how big that is? So Shaq's 7'1". So add another couple inches. He's probably a little taller, but I think Yao is a little bit sturdier. He's a bigger frame. His calves were about this big.
Ooh.
And his head was about that big. I played on the All-Star team my rookie year. So it was like a rookie All-Star team. We got a chance to go to the All-Star game, perform in front of everybody. I never got a chance to go to an All-Star team. Of course!
Cool.
Manu Bow, yeah! The King Baby Tumble, you see him in that Trush. Commercial?
Oh!
Doing that?
Yeah, I got him. I don't know how many times I got that guy.